todos y todas. Ustedes saben, yo soy un alemán que vive desde hace años en América Latina. Por eso yo me presento a mí mismo. Próxima sesión voy a hablar un poco no sobre ciencia, sino sobre Management of Science Cooperation in Latin America. So I will continue in English because what I'm presenting maybe could also be of interest for all the colleagues coming from the different Max Planck Institutes. So, you know, my name is Andreas Trepte. My office is in Buenos Aires. Buenos Aires because there is the unique partner institute of the Max Planck Society. So if you are thinking about careers at Max Planck, you have learned there are a lot of institutes in Germany, several in other countries, but the nearest one first is Florida, is in the Americas. And the next one, not as an original Max Planck Institute, but it is the partner institute of the Max Planck Society for Biosciences in Buenos Aires. In the same building is my office. And well, I will start talking because I'm talking a little bit about also the history of my work, because we started in 2013 with Colombia, with a visit of the president of the Max Planck Society in Colombia, and as a result, you will see from nearby nothing in the cooperation, we have established something, and I hope that we could continue growing in the relation with you. Again, as I said, the majority of the institutes, 79, are distributed in Germany, most of all nearby to the campus of a university. It's also important for cooperation, but also if you would like to make your doctoral degree, this is a doctoral degree you will receive in Heidelberg from the University of Heidelberg, in Berlin from one of the Berlin universities, with a stamp also from the Max Planck Institute, where you will do your research work. International cooperation, why? Because when I entered the Max Planck Society 28 years ago, the majority of the directors were Germans. The big majority of doctoral students were Germans. Today, starting from the top, 40% of directors are foreigners, or people with a passport from another country. Postdocs, the workhorses in the laboratories, group leaders, 85 to 90%. Doctoral students, 60%. So it's not necessary first to learn German to come to a Max Planck Institute. You need English, because your neighbor will be a Russian, or a Korean, or a scientist from India, and not a German. Or maybe the technician is a German, or the secretary of the director. But in general, you should know, we are one of the most internationalized institutions. And this is at home, inside of the institutes, and this is abroad. Therefore, we learned with Latin America, normally the Max Planck Society, our institutes, we have really few agreements. We learned here, we heard today something about law, the rule of law in Latin America. For the universities, this means if we would like to cooperate as Max Planck with a university, first we need a framework agreement. Well, need 6 months or more to come to a framework agreement. Later we need a more detailed cooperation agreement. All this normally we don't need. But we have now several dozens of agreements, not only in Colombia, but all over Latin America. Of course, we have a lot of ad hoc, I name it ad hoc research projects, between people. Because one has the organism, the other has the analytics, or whatever. They are publishing jointly, but there is no institutional link. It's only between friends, colleagues. So, we are today in the middle of something here, an exploratory symposium, because we are trying to look where people at Max Planck and in Colombia are working at the same time, more or less at the same topic, and could there be any kind of synergy? But internationalization of research means today there could be joint fellowship programs, for example, with Cosciencias in Colombia or with the Future Ministry. There could be a call for projects, Colombia, Max Planck, so that starting corporations could be deepened, could be developed. And, as you know, we have several joint, associated research groups between Colombia and Max Planck Institutes. But you see also, this requires a lot of coordination. And you know your country, you know your continent. Communication, regular visits are very important. So if you look in detail, and this is also the part, let's say, with information for young people which are really interested. All Max Planck institutes normally are making calls, individual calls from projects because they are looking for PhD students. Organized calls from the so-called international Max Planck research schools that are graduated schools for doctoral students. All this is published in the internet. We are receiving all over the institutes a lot of applications, but only a few one from Latin America. So my comment is, please help me to raise this number. You will see, or you could see it here you could see it here. 130 Colombians at today, more or less, are at Max Planck Institutes. But it could be much more so. Some are finding the way, some are trying to enter one of these research schools. And there are also now, they are starting now, just now, three new Max Planck schools. You could think in something like Harvard Business School, Harvard Law School, you have now also Max Planck schools in very interdisciplinary areas like cognition is one. The other one is matter and life. So at the interface between biosciences and natural sciences, exact sciences, or photonics. The same is true what I said. It is published in the internet. It is published on the web pages of these institutes when they are looking for postdocs. But again, these institutes are different from, let's say, a research center, un centro de investigación in Argentina, Chile, or in Colombia. Why? Because Max Planck institutes are funded by the Max Planck Society, and they have an internal structure and a budget which allows them to realize their research program without third-party funding. Though they have their own stuff, they have their funds for cooperation, their funds for stipends, their funds to buy new equipment. So they are much more flexible than, for example, universities like yours. Because you have to wait, scientists have to wait for the next call from Cosciencias or from the Future Ministry or maybe a project in the European Community Program. This is not the case at the Max Planck Institutes. Of course, scientists at Max Planck Institutes could apply, and they are doing this very successfully, in external programs. But this is special conditions. They are not only very autonomous, they are very fast in a lot of tasks they are fulfilling in research. So if you would like to enter into an institute, there is this formal way. But for example, for postdocs, there is always the way to propose a project, to look in which institute this kind of research is done. Is my project bringing also an added value to this institute? And to send a proposal to the director or research group leader in this institute. You could do this always, at any moment. So, I mentioned there are spontaneous organized research projects with Latin America, but I have to comment. Every year, Max Planck Institutes are maintaining 4,000 or 5,000 of these ad hoc research projects, and only 150 are with Latin America, and 10% or less than 10%, 14 were with Colombia last year. So there's a lot of room where new corporations, new links, new exchange of young people could be developed. But again, we are here to inform you, the speakers, the representatives of universities, but now, la pelota está en el campo de Colombia. You have to act. You have to take the initiative. You have to look into the internet. When will the next program in solar physics start in Göttingen? And then prepare an application. Nobody after this symposium will contact you again. Yeah? So please take this into consideration. So plan for next year is really to have a joint call with Cosciencias, and I hope that the new ministry will not only be a new institution, but also will have a new, bigger budget than Cosciencias today. We have two different kinds of research groups. For those which are doing their postdoc, because a person with a doctoral degree is not qualified, let's say, to be head of a research group. We need more experienced researchers. And there are two categories. One is the so-called partner groups. This is a program of the Max Planck Society for those postdocs, for example, the Colombia, which would like to go back to their country and which are really excellent in their scientific output during their research time at the Max Planck Institute. Minimum 1 year you have to be at the Max Planck Institute, then if your director would support you, you could apply during the year in this program. And you will see, I have mentioned it. The first group is now has been established at the University Uni Norte in Barranquilla. So, si se puede, se podría decir, no? We could say, it's possible. But it is a solution for persons. And this person, as a postdoc, is a specialist. So he is also defining the topic, and he's defining which institute could be, or which university, which faculty could be then the host for this group. But we have a second category, which are the tandem groups. And with these tandem groups, we started in Colombia because there were joint thematic interests, but no postdocs from Colombia. So one way is we know the person and we help the person that this person could reintegrate in his university or in a different university. The other way is there is a research topic where one or several Max Planck institutes and a university or research center in Colombia or in other countries would like to cooperate. Then, in the case of Colombia, we are organizing an international call. We are selecting between the applicants, the best candidates, and in a selection symposium, in live interviews and presentations, the candidates, or let's say the final candidate, the future group leader is selected. So I hope you understand we are an institution which is not a university. We are very decentralized, but there are a lot of opportunities for doctoral students, for postdocs, and even there is a support to come back to the home country, in your case to Colombia. So here you see the names of the and topics of the six groups which are at the moment working at the National University, at the University of Antioquia, Los Andes, and Cali. We hope that the number of groups will increase, but this depends from the research interests of our institutes And also from the initiative and the availability of funding in Colombia. So, during the last 6 years, you see, we infected a little bit Latin America, because what you are seeing is a development of research groups headed by former postdocs or internationally recruited postdocs in as leaders for tandem groups and research groups, partner groups in Latin America. So for me, for next year, we would like to negotiate with the ministry in Colombia a program for fellowships, because the institutes, Max Planck Institute, are open. And as I said, every year so many programs for doctoral students are open. There are fellowships from the Max Planck Society, but the majority is financed by fellowships from national institutions like Cosciencias or German institutions like the German Academic Exchange Service, DRD, or the Humboldt Foundation for postdocs. Well, we are inside of the symposium, and you see we are trying to extend the network of corporations. Next candidate maybe could be the university, Universidad del Rosario. So, to resume, all the information what I am presenting is normally available. And as you know, I am living in between Latin Americans, so I know English is a challenge. It's a challenge to take the initiative, but I could only say, we offer you at this Spanish website, which is handled by my office, all informations about upcoming calls in Max Planck Institutes, which could be of interest for you. For you means for young people, excellent master students, which would like to make their PhD in one of these programs of Max Planck, or for established profs, young profs, which would like to make a postdoc in a Max Planck Institute. So this page is available. We have the same information for those which are preferring this kind of US-American communication in Facebook. So you find us also there. And you know, our office, we are in Buenos Aires, we are speaking German, English, and Spanish. So please feel invited to contact us so that we jointly could develop the cooperation. But always you should have in mind, Max Planck Institutes are leaders in their research field at the international level. A cooperation with Colombia or with whatever country in the world, whatever institution, should also have a value added for our institute. So the proposals should be really at the frontiers of science, but the institutes are big. We are in total some 22,000-23,000 people. So feel invited to be part of this endeavor at Max Planck. Thank you so much, and here's my contact email. And feel free to ask questions if you like. Thank you so much.